What's up, guys? It's Kelly, and today I've got another swatch review for you. So make sure you hit that subscribe button and the notification bell so you don't miss out on new videos, and let's get started. So today I am sharing swatches of the Holo Taco Frosted Metals Collection for winter slash holiday 2020. So we've got five brand new polishes, and they all have a frosty foiled metallic finish to them. If you guys haven't heard of Holo Taco before, they are a nail polish brand created by fellow YouTuber Christine of Simply Nailogical. These polishes are based in the US and they are five free, meaning they are free of five of the dangerous chemicals that are often found in nail polish. They are vegan and they are cruelty free. So yeah, like I said, we've got five brand new polishes to go over. So I'm going to be showing you guys swatches of all of those on their own. And then I'm also going to be showing you guys swatches of all of these over a similar base color. I was just doing a little experimenting, so I'll show you guys that at the end of the swatches. But yeah, before I spoil anything, let's just get started. So roll footage. So as always with my swatch review videos, I am going to be using base coat underneath all of my swatches just to protect my natural nail and prevent any stains. Today I am using the Cuccio base coat. So first up in this collection, we have the shade Fake Date, which is a cool toned pink base that features a variety of irregular silver flecks running throughout. So as you can see on the first coat, it definitely does have that jelly-like feel to it. It is in a jellied base, but you can build it up to full coverage. I ended up doing three coats on this one for full coverage, and I think that looked best. You can definitely get away with two coats if you don't mind a little bit of visible nail line, but I feel like you get the best depth of color when you do those three coats, and it looks really gorgeous, very reflective, and pretty interesting with all the different silver flakes. And especially once you start to get a little bit of that layering, you get some of the flakes looking a little bit pinky because they are underneath some more of that base color. So overall, it has just a really cool effect on the nails, and it's just super sparkly and shiny. Next up, we have the shade Cheap Champagne, and this one is an orange jelly that has an array of these almost like champagne-y golden flecks running throughout. And again, we've got that nice variety of different sizes and irregularity, so it really has a ton of sparkle on the nails. This one was also pretty sheer in the first coat, but I ended up getting full coverage in two. I did a little bit of a thicker coat on the second, and I think that's the way to go if you want to make these a two coater. But again, I also think it's totally fine to do three thin coats, and it also looks just as good. So yeah, just another really pretty color. I love the contrast between the almost cool toned like champagne-y gold flecks with the really warm toned orange base. I just think they look really nice together. Next up, we have the shade Mint Money, and this was the one I was the most excited about because it's definitely a really beautiful and unique color. So this one, as you would expect from the name, has a really nice minty green with a little bit of a blue undertone base to it, and then it does have all of those really beautiful silver flecks running throughout. This one was another one that I ended up getting full coverage in three coats, and I just absolutely love this color. I think it is so pretty and wintry. It would be a great option for the holidays because it's that nice soft green, but it's more on the subtle side, so it's not like in your face holiday color, which I think is really cool. But yeah, just overall, three coats I thought was absolutely perfect. Looked so sparkly and pretty on the nails, and I just love the dimension that it gives with that green base kind of overlapping over the silver to create this dimensionality. Next up, we have the shade Cold Shoulder, and this one actually ended up being my favorite in the collection once I applied it on the nails. It's just a really beautiful cobalt blue base that has those silver flecks running throughout, and once you start applying it, some of those silvery flecks get a little bit of the blue on it, and it just creates such a beautiful bluey silver kind of vibe. This one was another one that I was able to get full coverage in two coats. It looks absolutely gorgeous on. This is a great Hanukkah color if you are looking for one because it really encompasses that whole blue silver vibe, and it just looks so beautiful on the nails. I love that combination with the glitters. I think they look so gorgeous with the layers. Oh, I totally love this one. And finally in this collection, we have the shade Gift Receipt, and this one is just a really sparkly silvery chrome polish. And this one I also ended up doing three coats for full coverage. I probably could have gotten away with two if I had done thicker coats, but I just wanted to get the formula nice and smooth and level on the nails, so I just went with nice thinner coats, and I think it looks absolutely gorgeous on. It is so reflective and sparkly. It honestly just looks like aluminum foil. Like, you can almost get a reflection of yourself in these nails. They're so fun. But I also love the different textures and the glitters, and I love the way that as you turn your nail, it kind of catches the light really beautifully. It's just a really nice silver, and it's a little bit almost on the warm side. It's not as cool of a silver as I would have expected, so it definitely creates a little bit of a uniqueness to this color. So definitely enjoyed this one, another really beautiful shade. You can actually see me a little bit in the reflection of the top area of my nails. You can see like that beige colored skin that's moving around. That's me. So here are all of these shades in the collection together, just so you guys can see how they look as a set. And we do have ourselves a pretty cohesive collection. Even though they are all different base colors, they do all have the same type of glitter flake in it, and they all just look really nice together. So definitely a cool looking set. I would have loved to see a gold in here just because I always associate gold with the winter holidays, but I definitely love the silver as well. So really happy with this one. So now that you guys have seen all of these polishes on their own, I wanted to do a little bit of experimenting and show you guys what these look like over similar base colors. Now, to be honest, this was kind of a failed experiment, but I figured I would show you anyway, just in case anybody is curious. But yeah, I saw in the comments of Simply Nailogical's video, somebody was asking what these colors would look like over a similar base color, and I was curious myself, so I just went for it. But yeah, that's something that I like to do with a lot of jelly polishes. So I ended up picking a similar base for each of the polishes in this collection. And to be totally honest, I did not love how these turned out. One of the things that I love about jelly nail polishes is as you build up the coverage, you get more depth of color, and then you also get some of those glitters get partially covered by the color, which makes it look way more dimensional and looks way cooler. So yeah, I feel like they kind of fell flat when they were over a base color. These polishes seem definitely intended to be worn on their own. But yeah, like I said, I just figured in case anybody was curious to see how those looked, I would just throw in that footage anyway so you could see what I was working with. But yeah, so aside from my somewhat failed experiment, I did really enjoy this collection. It's very much in line with the trends that I've been seeing with nail polish, with these kind of frosty metallic finishes, so I really do like to see that. And I also appreciate that these polishes aren't necessarily denominational colors, like they are very much winter polishes and not just polishes for the December holidays, so I really do love seeing that as well. So yeah, all of these polishes are available on the Holotaco website. The bottles are 12 milliliters each and they retail for $13 USD per bottle. So I will link that down below for you guys so you can check them out if you're interested. But yeah, I would love to hear from you guys. What do you think of these shades? Have you ordered any yet? Let me know in the comments. You know I love to chat with you. If you enjoy my swatch and review videos, please give this one a thumbs up. Lets me know I'm doing a good job. And if you're not already subscribed to my channel, please consider subscribing. I put out new videos every Tuesday, Friday, and Sunday. I know that I'm uploading this on a Monday, and I've also been doing some Thursday videos because I am just a crazy person. So yeah, you'll be getting a lot of videos this holiday season, but outside of these 2 months, I really do Tuesday, Friday, Sunday videos. So yeah. But yeah, so that is it, and I will see you guys in the next video. Bye. All right, today's fun fact question comes from Patreon supporter Autumn. And Autumn wants to know, do you have any super random facts about anything that you don't remember where you learned it? I feel like my brain is just full of random knowledge, mostly just like things that I will never use in real life. And I mean, honestly, I don't remember specifically where I get this information, but it's generally just the internet. But now that I'm like being confronted with this question, I cannot think of anything. I do know that one strand of spaghetti is called a spaghetto, and I feel like that's something that's pretty important to know. So now you guys know if you didn't already. But yeah, that's it. I'll see you guys in the next video. Bye.